This MacBook Pro mid-2012, as its name suggests, was released like 12 years ago. And let's see how this device performs in 2024. So the good thing with this model, the 2012 model, is the fact that you can actually upgrade RAM and SSD, which I've done on mine. And if I go to About Mac, you'll see that this one has a 2.9 dual core Intel Core i7 with 16 gigs of RAM and an SSD. So this device was actually Apple stopped supporting this device long time ago, and the latest macOS that this one was able to support was macOS Catalina. However, it's a bunch of guys that they've got this project called Open Core Legacy Patcher, and what that does actually gives you the opportunity to bring back to today's standards all devices like this one. So on mine, I have installed Open Core Legacy Patcher, and my 2012 device runs macOS Sonoma. Crazy, right? And actually, to my surprise, runs exactly very, very much as you would expect from a device that runs the latest OS. Like, tabs open quite fast, multiple tabs, so like that, from Finder to the browser, apps, la la la, etc. etc. Now, purposely, I got this device just to actually make the project like, can we make the MacBook 2012 run the latest OS? Or at least, can we bring it forward? So let's say forward in the future, in today's standards, with any patches. And yes, we can. So if you've got a MacBook, MacBook Pro, MacBook Air, iMac, between 2008 until 2017, check Open Core Legacy Patcher, because most likely your device can be useful again. Useful in a way that you would be able to use the device as a daily driver. I use this MacBook Pro as my daily driver. I used to have and still have a Lenovo laptop, 2017 model, running Windows 10 Pro, blah blah blah. Yeah, okay, that is on the side now, because this MacBook Pro covers up everything, like no hiccups, performs great, and is mind blowing the fact that this one is a 2012 model. So for daily use, works fine. Browsing, emails, iMessages, FaceTime, you name it. Let's see, actually, if we can play a game on this. Well, not like MacBooks are good for gaming, but you know, those average games that you can find on App Store, like Asphalt 9 or something. Let's go and download Asphalt 9, by the way, because I thought I had it downloaded already, but turns out I don't. So let's go Asphalt 9. As you can see, it's very responsive, like. So let's go and download Asphalt 9 Legends. And let's see how this 2012 MacBook Pro performs. while the game is been in the download process, let's have a quick walk around, say in terms of browsing, how this MacBook Pro performs to give you a better view. So if we go to, let's say, apple.com, you continue, that's the Apple website, scrolls fine, and actually it's very smooth. And if we go, let's say, I don't know, browse a bit around the tabs, obviously that little lagginess is because of the internet connection. So if your internet connection is let's say slow, then your browsing experience probably will be slow as well. So runs fine. Now, I don't know, let's open a second tab and let's go GSM Arena. There you go. Works fine. And then if I do one more and let's go YouTube. It's like this few seconds lateness, it's something that nobody would mind. Like, it doesn't take so long to actually load a page and you're like, oh god, why is that taking so long? So I would suggest, if you've got a MacBook that you can actually upgrade in terms of storage and RAM, do that first. Max the upgrades on your machine and then go ahead and install OpenCore Legacy Patcher. Install an OpenCore Legacy Patcher, it's a very straightforward process, especially when you actually follow the steps from the official OpenCore Legacy Patcher website. So if I go and do search here, OpenCore Legacy Patcher, and we go to the website, that is the actual website. The steps of installing the patcher, like I said, they are very, very simple. You need a USB stick, at least 16 gigs. Make sure that you've got backup of your stuff on the current OS of your Mac, because this process will erase everything from your hard drive or SSD and dive straight into it. The steps are here. They are very detailed steps. These guys who actually started this project and they keep developing the project, they're great. I wouldn't have thought that my MacBook, or for that matter any MacBook that is considered obsolete or has or Apple has dropped support for, that they will be able to run the latest OS. So yeah, do this and actually you will not regret it. And again, huge reminder one more time, if you're gonna go through this path, make sure that you've got backup, make sure that your machine is maxed in terms of upgrades, so you'll have the best possible experience. So yeah, I'm very happy with this machine. It wasn't very good when I had Catalina, obviously, installed on it, because Catalina is not supported anymore. And I wanted so badly to actually make it work with the latest OS. One thing that I've noticed, though, is like when you're trying to actually edit videos through using CapCut, takes a crazy amount of time to actually extract the video. It doesn't take that long when you do the same process with iMovie. With iMovie, the process is it is faster, let's say. But again, I don't mind because I know this one is a 12-year-old device and yet still runs great. So, bottom line for me is like you don't need to buy a new MacBook if you can actually make your old MacBook run the latest OS. Or say if your MacBook doesn't support the latest OS but supports the second latest OS, instead of Sonoma, you go for Ventura, for example. Again, you save yourself money and you actually keep using a device that is not dead yet. So, during this video, I said that I will try the Asphalt 9. So, the Asphalt 9 game now has been downloaded. Let's open the game and let's see how that will perform. Because, again, like I said, I don't really game on my MacBook. I use it for everyday general stuff, but once in a while, I want to actually try and play some games on it. But yeah, and while this one is loading, I want to mention that the SD card reader, it doesn't work. Well, I don't know now because I've done OS update. I am on Sonoma. I don't know whether the reader itself wasn't working in the first place to begin with, or it stopped working because of the update. Regardless, doesn't really matter because, yeah. So let's do this one quickly. Age, well, random is, I'm not 39 by the way, but yeah, okay. Let's see how this one will go. I won't be bothered to actually log in to Game Center. So just let's say continue with current because I played that once. So the fan has kicked in. I don't know if you can actually hear that, but all right, it is, I guess, an intensive app for this Mac. But yeah, anyway, let's see. By the way, this game has very, very good graphics. So nice. So, but I know I'm not a good gamer. I don't game. So, if I actually total this car, yeah, okay. So, what did I say there? Yeah, all right, okay. All right. S and the arrow. Okay. All right, thing is, like I said, it works very well. I mean, I don't see any drops in terms of frames, but yeah, I mean, if you, yeah, there you go, you had a bit of lag there. Yeah, okay. Where the D. But yeah, like if you want a casual game, just once in a while, it will perform just fine. Well, hiccups here and there, but yeah. So, let's actually come on. Yeah, okay, move. Hey, so that's all right, great. So if I close down this game now, because okay, we had too much fun with that. So conclusion of this video: if you've got a MacBook Pro, MacBook Air, iMac from 2008 up to 2017, as the this project stands as of right now, you can actually make your device run the latest or the closest to latest OS. So it's worth trying. Again, make sure that you've got backed up your important documents, files, and give it a go. Because, yeah, from personal experience here, I like it. I'm very glad that these people who are behind the Open Core Legacy Patcher, they're doing so amazing job, and they actually give life again to these old machines. So that's it from me, guys. Thank you very much for watching. Let me know in the comment section below what MacBook you've got and whether you will try to install Open Core Legacy Patcher. And of course, if you've got any questions, please drop them in the comment section below. I will try to help you as much as I can. And yeah, don't forget to give this video a like and subscribe to this channel for more content, and I'll catch you in the next one.